Hello, peeps, and welcome back to Material Energy Cubed. Alright, so, let's pick up where we left off. As promised, I went ahead and moved all of the crap from downstairs to upstairs. It's in these chests here. I noticed a couple of things while I was doing this. First of all, there was a rather alarming amount of dirt down there. 881 dirt, minus the top layer that I left and the stairs that I left. I went ahead and grabbed the chest and the skeleton skulls too, waste not, want not. But I noticed a couple of other things while I was down there, and I want to go check those out before I get started on the episode. Actually, I'm going to need some dirt for these. Being as dirt is my most plentiful resource at the moment. First of all, I bet there's something up there. Because that's just too conspicuous. Yep. Carpenter safe there. Oh, it's storming outside. Real good. But yeah, this shovel's actually turning out to be a really good choice. It's lasted a long time. And then I also have a reward bag in here that I want to open too. So I've got two good reward bags. Let's go ahead and open them real quick. First is an arborist chest and a grafter for forestry stuff later. The second is Parcel 31U, a storage unit. No idea what that does. I'll check it out in a little bit. I also have the obsidian and the biosphere things here. These ender chests are labeled spatial drive storage, so I've just been keeping all the drives in here. Which I guess makes sense, it keeps it easier to get to with controls. And that thing there is extremely conspicuous, and if you jump, you can see that there's something in there. I'm sure they're not always going to be this conspicuous, but... Okay, let's go ahead and grab some sugar. And down we go. Okay, where are we at on our quests? It says I have two quests with unclaimed rewards. It's actually down here in Lost and Found. The inclusion chamber and the biosphere. In case you happen to lose the discs, you can get them back with these. Alright, as far as the actual quests that we're doing, though, we're working on the Left Alone quest line. And there's a quartz challenge, which is to gather 200 quartz. Now, this is about as far as I got in my first playthrough. I did do a couple more quests here and there, some of the pay-to-win stuff I checked out. But I looked around forever for quartz in this frickin' inclusion chamber, and it says, hint, it's somewhere in the inclusion chamber. I looked around for a bloody decade, it felt like, for this damn stuff. And I mined up almost every section of almost every section of cobblestone down there. I found some oraclasium or whatever the fuck it is, and that was a zombie breaking a torch, so that's awesome. And I made a pickaxe, and I burned through almost the entire damn pickaxe, and I was on my way back up without a single piece of quartz to my name. I'm like, son of a bitch, where do I find all that quartz? Wait a second. There's your quartz. Yeah, it's in the inclusion chamber, alright. The entire room's made of it. Now, Electrum, I found. It's this Electrum pickaxe that you get. Tears through quartz really fast, but has very low durability. Tears through quartz and cobblestone pretty fast, but it's worthless for mining some of the heavier, harder metals. But I may as well burn the pickaxe off. And it's gone. Shadow steel. Not nearly as fast. Hadroth is a pretty good balance. Hey, what's that? That's marble. We're just going to gather a good amount of this stuff. Sometimes it pays to look behind stuff, too. Actually, I didn't even know that was there. That's a happy little surprise. But yeah, in the biosphere, which is about as far as I got in this whole thing, I started playing around with the biosphere, and that's where stuff gets really hairy, and I didn't want to do too much and ruin the surprise for myself. But yeah, in the biosphere, there's a lot of chests hidden all over the place, so I kind of got in the habit of looking for them. Alright, the quartz challenge is done. Pick one. Seraclase helmet and Seraclase boots. I think I want the helmet because it's made of more ingots. I have no idea how rare Seraclase is, but if I can get 5 ingots worth instead of 4 ingots worth, that seems like the way to go. Let's head out of here and put this stuff away. And then I will show you guys the pay-to-win challenge. If I can get my throat cleared, damn. And we're going to put this stuff away, put the excess quartz away. I got some extra utilities pipes. That'll be handy in the near future. A music disc, a fully charged leadstone energy cell. That's cool. An Eye of Ender. Splash potion and healing. That could be useful down the road. Let's check the reward bags real quick. We got a basic, which is another time machine. And gene samples. Vaporine, Industrious, and Imperial. Holy crap, that lets us skip a lot of bee breeding. Not that it's difficult with Gendustry, but... Okay, let's do the pay-to-win thing. Pay-to-win allows you to exchange these coins from metallurgy for items. We can start out with a basic reward bag, which will cost us 8 coins. Got us 10 leather. And that quest is repeatable. You can repeat it once every 4 hours. And those are real life hours, not in-game hours. But that opens up the good reward bag, which takes 5 stacks. Well, a stack is 8 coins, or 9 coins. I don't have any stacks yet, so we're going to have to wait on that. But that's what the whole pay-to-win thing is about. Let's go back to... Oh, we have side quests open now. Side quests allows you to... Yeah, abstractors. Metallurgy apparently has a thing called an abstractor, which will let you put unwanted metal into it and get experience out. So if you find yourself absolutely swimming in a certain type of metal, you can use these abstractors to get some good stuff. Now, as far as the abstractors go, the better the abstractor, the faster they go, I guess. I don't think it gets you any more experience. I think you just get it faster. Let's go ahead and do a little more mining down here before we go on to the next part of Left Alone. Because there's an even more mining quest that wants you to get 2 stacks of cobble, 5 gold ore, 5 iron ore, and a diamond. Now, we've already got the gold and the iron ore, but we need the diamond, and I'm actually going to go get the survivalist pickaxe. Because I don't have a good pick on me. The 2 that I have are very close to breaking. I want to save those for metals. And then there's also one other thing that I want to check out before I get too far into the episode here. When I was emptying out, or hollowing out down here, I noticed something in the floor there. You see it? Yeah, you see what's guarding it? Ugh. Why does it have to be spiders? Always spiders, too. Oh man, this pickaxe sucks. Jesus. Maybe we won't do this right now, because I have no armor, no pickaxe to break the corner blocks out with, and no weapon. Yeah, we're not going to mess with that for now. Those spiders can go jump off a ledge. Let's go mine. This looks all the world to me like it should be a carpenter block because of the lighting bug, but it's not. Alright. We take a look in here. We also have a quest for fertilizer, liquid coal, which we can actually complete because we got 3 buckets of liquid coal. Death. And get a heart. If you die 2 times, you get a reward bag. Either 4 block of diamond nooks or a coin. It takes 32 block of diamond nooks to make a block of diamond, so unless you get 32 of these throughout the course of the game, I don't see why that's worthwhile. But who knows. Let's go ahead and... Oh, we can get the magnesium with this pickaxe. Good. Can we get iron? Yes, we can gather iron with this too. And we can get cobblestone. But there's something else that I want to get. And I found this on my last playthrough, so I know it's here. There we go. Yeah. In here, there is a box called Secret that has a bunch of different ingots in it. And then there's also this rubracium all over the place here. And then there's this orichalcum, which is too hard for me to mine right now. But, oh, can I seriously not mine this at all? I seriously can't mine it at all. Well, we'll have to come back for that then. The Haderoth pickaxe that I had could have mined it. So I screwed up. And then this is phosphorite. Ooh, hello. Ooh, emeralds. And potash. We need the potash. Actually, the survivalist pickaxe is doing better than I thought it would. I can even harvest redstone with it, just very slowly. Get some lapis. Potash ore. And there's some more redstone. I don't want to get too heavy into the mining right now, because mining's boring stuff. I do want to get some sulfur. And there's another chest down there. With a Haderoth pickaxe and a super miner. Awesome. There's a diamond. That gets us our diamond to complete the quest. And then this Haderoth pickaxe, I bet, can get this rubros. Oh! Gatling skeleton. They fire really fast. They don't do much damage, but they fire really fast. Yeah, unsecured mines, very dangerous. Alright, let's take that Haderoth pickaxe that I got and see if I can mine. Yes. Oh, wait, that's for... Yes, I can get the orichalcum or whatever it is. Let me out. That's also just an overall better pick. Now, I haven't played around with the super miner. Let's see what this does. Haste potion potency 99. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. This should be interesting. Holy fuck! Holy shit! Oh, I made a mistake. I done did goofed. I have opened a portal to spider hell. Not a very big portal, though. Maybe this is actually going to work out in my favor a little bit. Give me a way to kill all those spiders up there. Without getting hit too much myself. Yeah, it might actually work out in my favor. How much cobblestone have I got? That superminer's crazy shit. Man, that was... Holy crap. I obliterated this place. Okay. Where can I get more of that? Hey, Mikey, I think he likes it. I did break a hole in the... side. Whoa! Whoa! Fuck you! I broke a hole in the side of this. I don't think it matters, but I'm putting it back together anyway. Oh, hi. Hi, Desert Spider. Desert Spiders give you sand when they die instead of giving you string. It's kind of weird. See? Okay, this is probably a bad idea. I'm burning through sucrose so fast. Hello? Ow. Hello? You die now? Haha, success. Wait, what's this? Oh, hey. Leave me alone. Prick. This is the stairway down. White wool. Okay, then. Renamed White Wool. VM for Victory Monument, I guess. I'm just going to keep the arrow. The sandstone's easy enough to make. And over here, I've got some... I think this is sugar. Sand's easy enough to get. Yeah, it's sugar. Alright. How much cobblestone do I have? Almost enough. I need 2 stacks. I actually probably should repair the hole that I put in the roof here. So that I won't have spiders jumping down on me. Damn. Not quite enough. I'll repair it with a little bit of cobblestone. I'm gonna burn off the last of the shadow steel pick. And the Viroxeries pick while I'm at it. Alright. I should be able to... Oh, no, I gotta go back upstairs. Because I don't have the gold on me. What are you doing down here, cow? And pig. They are migrating. The Great Migration. Fucking hunger. If he wanted to be a real prick, he would have included Spice of Life. That would have sucked on this map. That's the one where you get less hunger return after every X amount of times you eat. Oh, that would have sucked. Okay, let's go ahead and put the emeralds up. I need to keep the iron on me. I need to keep the cobblestone on me. Let's put all of these ingots away. And let's get some more gold out so I can complete this stupid quest. I'm gonna put all of these other ores in the Victory Monument pool away. And now we're gonna complete even more mining. That gets us 4 diamonds, reward bag, 2 more of those super miners. Ho ho. Miner's Delight. I haven't opened the Miner's Delight thing yet. Ooh, 30 redstone ore. Nice. I've never opened the Miner's Delight world yet, so I don't know what's waiting for me in there. I imagine it's bad shit. Anything named Delight always draws a little bit of wariness from me. Alright, the liquefacted coal we can just get from here. And that'll give us another reward bag, plus some more coal, and we get to keep our original coal. 30 more redstone ore. Not quite as awe-inspiring the second time around, but still good. Redstone's always useful. Death. I haven't died at all yet, so I don't intend to die if I can avoid it. Fertilizer. If you take phosphorus, potash, and magnesium, you get fertilizer. Now, for some reason, it doesn't count this properly. Even though I made 8 fertilizer, it only counted that as 2. I don't know why. I noticed that when I was testing this earlier. And see, even there, that only counts as 4. You have to make 24 of these in order to get credit for making 5. Melon seeds and a reward bag. Reward bag is a good. Iron ladders, iron bars, and an experience drain. Well, the experience drain will help if I start dying a lot. And siphon off my experience and store it in tanks. Magnesium, melon seeds. I probably should go ahead and plant these melons. I'm gonna hold off on it for now. We're okay with sugar water for right now. I'm just gonna put those away. Alright, and let's see what's next. Even more mining, liquid coal. Why is that not unlocked? Do I have to die twice in order to unlock that? Biosphere. Yeah, you have unlimited lives, and you are going to die. A lot. Alright, it wants me to gather 3 moss stone, 3 lava stone, 3 limestone, and 3 sandstone. Go ahead and load the biosphere. First, we need to unload the inclusion chamber, remember. So we're going to put the inclusion chamber right there. We're going to unload it. And now we're going to load the biosphere. Now, I've poked around in the biosphere. I know it's a scary fucking place, but I haven't completed the biosphere quest yet, so... Alright, so the moss stone I need is right here. There's a spider behind me. One of these stupid desert spiders. I seriously need to get a weapon. Okay, here's some limestone over here. Oh shit, that's a skeleton. That's a skeleton wearing a helmet. What the hell? What the hell? What the crap? Leave me alone. More limestone, please. Sugar, please. I hear a skeleton. Okay, holy crap. I need some of this lava stone. Which scares the shit out of me. Oh, yeah. The thing I was talking about earlier where it's worthwhile to look behind stuff. If you look up here, there's a chest up there. And then there's another one hidden around behind the back of that. Bunch of coins and a couple bags. And then I need sandstone, I think, is the last thing I need. Yeah, 3 sandstone. Whoa, that's a dirt creeper. No! Ow. And it begins. There's one. Yeah, fuck it. The most certain way to die is lava. I was actually swimming through the lava. Okay, now I've got my 2 deaths out of the way. I can claim the reward for the 2 deaths. If I don't get away from the spider, it's gonna be 3. Stupid spider. Alright, and I have a grave around here somewhere. Oh shit. Thief skeleton. Gold nuggets. Huh. Okay, let's go ahead and break the grave, get my stuff back out of it. Alright, and now I can complete that stupid death quest. I'm gonna take the 5 coins. And yeah, full heart, consume to get a life. Sorry, that mode's not on yet. Don't turn that mode on. Unless you're a total masochist, don't turn that mode on. Alright. 3 basic reward bags. We got some sucrose here. Alright, let's go over this way. And I can't remember if there was a chest in here. I'm sure there is somewhere. There's chests hidden all over the damn place. Torches would have helped. But what's going to help me more right now is the sand that's over here. And wrecking this spider shit. And that skeleton. What the shit? A named skeleton. Ornate cuisses of baking. What? Whatever. Sandstone. There, I got my sandstone. Let's get the fuck out of here. I need to light this place up like the surface of the goddamn sun. And then that won't help because the zombies will come by and destroy it all. Fuck! Leave me alone! Tactical retreat. Also known as run for your fucking life. I only have 7 sucrose left. That's not enough to fill me back up. Maybe I'll get some food from one of these bags. Medasium dust, accomplice and a clock, a better barrel, and a structural mark 1. Maybe not. Egyptian temple. Somewhere under the sand in the sandstone lies a small temple with strange carvings, guarded by snakes whose eyes can see through the night. What? Whatever. Viroxyne, Shadow Iron, or Sanguinite? I think I'm going to take the Sanguinite Axe. Penicillin coated. Don't ask me what penicillin coating does. I really don't know. I need food, like, real bad. But I currently have no way to move water. So I need to cook a little bit of my iron. I'm just going to use the pulverizer over here, which should pipe automatically into this redstone furnace here when it gets done, and then I can make a bucket. And I should have a crafting table around here somewhere, yep. Because I got it for killing the golem earlier. Pop that down there. There's my 4 iron. There's my bucket. And I'm just gonna put a very small farm over in the corner here. And I also want to create an infinite water source. Before I forget. Oops. Alright, and I think I also want to put... I want to plant my melon over there. I need a hoe. I don't have a hoe. I just realized this. I do have some wood. And that will give me just enough to make a hoe. A liquid transfer node? What the hell good is a liquid transfer node gonna do me? I'd rather have a regular transfer node. At least with that you can make a cobblestone gem. I mean, I guess I can make an infinite water supply with that, but... Alright, but I don't have any liquid pipes, so wouldn't do me any good anyway. I'm losing track. Yeah, fertilizer. Where's the fertilizer? There's the fertilizer. And I think I also want to put some torches down. I don't think it's strictly necessary. But I want to have my farm lit. Seeds. Let's go ahead and grow the tile pumpkin stem. Whatever. Alright. That'll get me enough bread to hold me over. Till I can get around to making a better farm. I think for the farm I'm just gonna bust through that wall and just build a platform of dirt. With a water tank and iron bars. Oh, what the shit? Where the hell did you come from? That's not going to happen. We're not going to have that. No, 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 no. I have dispensers for a reason. The game gave me this crap for a reason. It's time to use it. So, I think right here... we're going to put... a line of turrets. Yes, my turret army, defend me. And I can still fit through the middle. I wonder if you can upgrade those turrets. I'd imagine so, because I got the turret guide. I never stopped to read that. Follow manual, upgrade manual. turret upgrades apply bonuses to your turrets. Each turret can only have one upgrade. The upgrade item is never used up. Why give a turret to give or take an upgrade item? Some turrets do not take all upgrades. So I bet if you give the turret item, I bet if you give it to them, they hold on to it, and then if you right-click it, you can get it back. Diamond adds damage. Iron ingot adds fire. Feather, slime ball, ender pearl, spider eye, fire charge, ghast. Holy shit. So if I give them iron ingots, that makes them fire arrows? Whatever. We'll figure it out later. When we play around with that a little more. Okay. Egyptian Temple. DLC. Unlocks one quest. DLC? How the hell? Something I hate. You and me both, buddy. Two stacks. Do I have enough coins to make two stacks? Yes, barely. Alright, let's get our DLC. Mesa Caverns. We'll check that out later. Basic reward bag. Shovel kit and a pickaxe kit. Didn't I already get that? I know I already got that. Anyone else feel like you just got gypped? Feel like that when I download most DLCs. QDS. I'm sure I'm gonna need this QDS for something at some point. Let's just put it down now. So otherwise I'm gonna be looking through umpteen million pieces of crap looking for it later. Wondering why I can't find it. Okay, let's go ahead and take 3 pieces of this Invar and make ourselves an Invar sickle. Because this is going to allow me to chop trees a little easier. Alright. Egyptian Temple. I wonder if that's in Egyptian Temple. At the end of the river where it runs dry, away from the volcano and buried under sand, lies the A small temple. What? Alright, well, buried under the sand leads me to believe, you know what? There's a bunch of sand out there. I'm almost out of time for this episode anyway. Let's spend the last few minutes digging for treasure. And placing 15,000 fucking torches. Oh, bring it. I got an axe now. May not be an amazing weapon, but it's better than the one I had before, which was... You son of a bitch. Angry spider. So angry. Cows. Chest. Biomass, peats, copper gears. That's a forestry starter kit, I guess. Really probably should start doing some forestry stuff, like some farms. But wait, I haven't seen any copper yet, have I? Aside from the copper gears that I just picked up, I don't think I've seen any copper. You can't get to just a regular mining overworld. I don't think. Never really explored too much. No, 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 no. We're not playing this game. I'm going digging for buried treasure and you can't fucking stop me. Maybe they can. so I don't have any bread or food. Protect me, turrets. Should have some bone meal. Yeah. Just go ahead and get some bread. This episode's gonna run a little long. I don't care. I wanna go digging. Oh, shit. Broke my damn melon seeds. Well, that wasn't intentional. And, you know, it's not even worth me replanting the melon seeds right now, because I'll just knock them loose again. Bet the watering can's in here. Should make a watering can. It'd save me a lot of fertilizer. Of course, I don't know how plentiful that potash is gonna, or the fertilizer from the potash and the magnesium and shit is. I might be able to get enough to support myself with that. Fucking spiders! They're goddamn everywhere. Look at this. What fresh spider hell did you come out of? Oh, I'm gonna die again. Yep. Take my shitty wooden sword out. Recover my corpse. I want to know if there's treasure buried in the sand over there. I want to know real bad. That wooden sword was actually not that ineffective. I was expecting it to be a lot worse than that. Alright. We got everything? My pants broke already. Onward! For great justice. Screw you, spiders! Jesus! I hear an Enderman. Yeah, that's right, you die. Son of a bitch! It's just so many of the damn things. It's all over the place. Wait. Oh, shit! I'm so gonna die again. That's a stair. Oh, hey! There is treasure buried into the sand. A good reward bag. I somehow doubt this is what I'm after. 5 lava buckets, 64 lava stone, 5 lava cans, 16 buckets. We should have had that a few minutes ago when I needed the buckets. But it said something about a coin. There's a stairway here. Hi, Enderbro. You know what? Are you going to be generous and give me your Ender Pearl loots? Ooh, I don't wanna look at him too close. Until I can dig in here a little more. There we go. Now, you! Oh, he's a cursed Enderman. Spider Eye? What the shit kind of Enderman gives a Spider Eye? Whatever. I should know better than to expect anything on this mod pack. Oh, hello. A Quicksilver chest plate, a bunch of coins, and an Egyptian staff. Wow. And this is blocks of gold. Holy crap. Sandstone scribbles. Sandstone. Chiseled sandstone. That's pretty cool. So let's see if I can get out of here without dying. Get back to base. It's 46 minutes in, so I can't drag this out too much longer. I gotta go. But I want to see what I get for this Egyptian staff. Whoa, I made it out. Unbelievable. I made it out alive. Cue victory music. 5 lava buckets, 64 that. Let's go ahead and put this chest plate on. I need all the protection I can get right now. Holy crap, there's a ton of mobs in this. Probably keep the pickaxe. Alright. Where is... There it is. Egyptian temple. An escritor, a reward bag, and 20 coins. The reward bag is an epic reward bag. Ho ho. Oh, are we ready for this, guys? Epic reward bag. Let's see what we get. Fantasy medals. A miraculous reward. Fantasy medals. We are going to have to check that out next episode. But for right now, I gotta call it. This has been Night Dagger with episode 2 of... Yeah, what's this mod pack name? Material Energy Cubed. Hope you guys are enjoying the series so far. I know I'm enjoying playing it. I think I'm going to record one more episode tonight if I can get my render done in time. And probably... Oh, hello. May as well get this charging while I'm talking. I'll probably record one more episode tonight, so I will probably be able to start uploading them pretty soon. Like I said, I'm going to have to upload using my phone, so it's going to be very slow and painful and tedious. I'm probably only going to be able to upload one episode a day, but we'll see how things go. Hope you guys are enjoying the series. I'll catch you later, peeps.